Hey everyone, it's Lauren. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Thank you so much for joining me today. This video is going to be a review of a high quality basics brand and one that I've been wanting to try for quite a long time now, and that is Mott Bow. Someone from Mott Bow so kindly reached out to me and offered to send me some of these pieces in exchange for an honest review of them. The one thing in particular that I was most excited about trying was their denim. And I've done a few denim reviews on my channel already. If you haven't had a chance to see those videos, I'll make sure to link all that down for you below. Before I talk about these products, I want to throw out a huge disclaimer here that while these items were sent to me, I did not pay for them with my own money. I am going to be giving you an honest and thorough review of these items. Even if I was paid to talk about these products, I just want to reassure all of you that my opinions and views are going to be 100% unbiased, unfiltered, raw, and real, because at the end of the day, you guys matter. All of my viewers, all of my subscribers matter so much to me, and I never, ever, ever want to give the impression that I am giving an inauthentic view or something for financial gain, because that is absolutely something that I am not about. But I am interested in collaborations for several reasons. And the biggest one being is that I want to be able to find products that I can recommend to my viewers. A lot of the items that are in my personal wardrobe are purchased secondhand. That's primarily because that is a great way for me to save a lot of money and buy the highest quality items that I can for the lowest price possible. So while I can recommend certain brands and I can recommend certain fabric contents and things like that, it's hard for me to recommend specific pieces because a lot of the items I have, like I said, are purchased secondhand, and a lot of them are no longer available for you to purchase today. So it's important for me to be able to find high quality brands that I can recommend to all of you and give my honest opinion and views on. Okay, so the company sent me 5 items to try. I was able to pick and choose, and I have 3 tops and 2 pairs of denim to talk about today. I will also be providing a discount code for my viewers down below if you are interested in purchasing anything that I am talking about today. I do not receive financial compensation from that, but it is going to save you guys a little bit of money. So if you're going to purchase any of these pieces I talked about anyway, you might as well save a little bit of money. I'm also going to have timestamps down below in this video, like all of my videos. So if there's something that you want to skip ahead to, you're not going to hurt my feelings at all. So that will be down in the description below. Okay, so what is Mott Bow? Who is this brand? So they are an online-based brand and they specialize in high quality basics. So you're not gonna find any prints or patterns here. It's going to be basics like denim, sweatshirts, t-shirts, that sort of thing. As I'm going through these pieces for you guys, I'm gonna be rating them on a 5-star basis. So 5 stars meaning that I absolutely recommend it, think it's worth the money and the investment. 4 stars would be a great rating, almost perfect, but not quite. 3 stars is going to be a good rating, but it could use a few areas of improvement on that particular item. 2 stars, poor, would not recommend. And 1 star, I don't know if I really need to explain that, but that would be the absolute lowest rating, would be something that I would absolutely not recommend to you guys and would have a lot of issues with that particular item. The first item that I'm going to be talking about today is the light ribbed cotton cashmere crew, Emma. I'm going to be reading a couple of the product features directly from the website. The Emma is a lightweight ribbed crew sweater that is cozy and soft to the touch. It's made of 85% cotton and 15% cashmere. So I'm gonna come right off the bat and say that this was my absolute favorite piece. I give this a 5-star all the way. I absolutely loved the fit of it, the feel of it, and just how it looks. This is such a great high quality basic for so many different reasons. This top is made of 85% cotton and 15% cashmere. And because it has that little bit of cashmere blended into it, it's super soft and it's also a little bit warm as well. I sometimes struggle with ribbed tops because if they're too tight of a rib, it can work against me personally because I have curves on my body in all different places, but I found that this particular top was not too tight in the weave, so it just kind of graced over my curves very nicely. This is definitely a great high quality basic if you're in the market for something like this, and it also comes in white as well if you're not interested in the black. The next item that I'm going to be talking about is a cashmere sweater. I absolutely love cashmere. If you do not own any cashmere sweaters, I highly recommend that you have at least one in your wardrobe because it is such a versatile piece. And I find that cashmere is actually quite a bit warmer than wool. Even the thinnest of cashmere sweaters tend to be more warm than my merino wool pieces. It gets super cold where I live and I tend to run a little bit cold, so I really love being bundled up, and cashmere is just a great item for me personally to have in my wardrobe. So this piece is the Cambridge Raglan Crew Cambridge in the color cream. I gotta say, I love this piece as well. This is also going to get another 5-star rating from me. Now I will say I do love a slightly cropped fit so I can do an easy front tuck, but I like that this one is a regular length for me so I can wear it with skinny jeans, and I find it to be just very versatile. The Cambridge is a perfect mid-weight year-round sweater knit from the highest quality grade A cashmere yarn from Inner Mongolia. I found the sizing specifically in the tops in general with this brand, at least from the pieces that I have tried, that the fit was very consistent. I can't tell you how frustrating it is when you purchase something from a brand and the fit is absolutely great, beautiful, looks great on you, and then you go purchase something else and the fit is totally off. Cashmere is also very durable, and if it's taken care of properly, it can literally last you a lifetime. So that is something that I just really wanted to quickly note, is that I found the sizing, at least for me, to be very consistent in the tops. The final chop that I decided to try was the long sleeve crew tee Marcy in the color white. So this is a top that gets 5-star reviews on their website, and I'm going to actually be giving this a 3.5 stars. The biggest reason I'm giving it a 3-star rating is because it is completely see-through, you guys. This is not a white tee that you can wear on its own. It's something that you're going to have to layer with. The Marcy is a silky, soft, fitted tee. It's lightweight and pre-shrunk, so it won't shrink after wash. It's made of 50% Pima cotton, which is a high quality cotton, and 50% Modal. I'm sure that many of you can relate to this, but finding a white tee that is not see-through is so difficult to find. And yeah, this is definitely not an opaque tee at all. It's something that you're gonna have to layer with. Now, I will say that I love the fit of this tee, and I am somebody who tends to layer in the winter, so I like to have a merino wool tank top on underneath. And for a basic top like this, I would probably be wearing a scarf with it. So when you pair all those things together, it works for me. But in general, if you're just looking for a basic white tee, I would not go for this one. And like I said, in terms of fit and fabric quality, I think the quality is there. It's a thinner material, so just keep that in mind as well. I would highly recommend that you purchase it in the black or the gray instead of the white. I definitely think that you're going to be much happier with that purchase, but yeah. We're gonna move on to the last two pieces, which is going to be denim. Like many of you, I have a really, really hard time finding denim that fits my body type. To give a little background on my size, I am 5'8" and I tend to wear anywhere from a 30 to a 32 or a 10 or 12, just depending on the brand.
Something that I wanted to point out to you really quickly is their free home try-on program that Mott Bow offers. So essentially what you can do is order two pairs of denim, and they're not going to charge you for both pairs, just so that you have that ability to try on a couple different sizes. And I really think that that is great, especially for a brand that, you know, you can't try on in store. Your only option is to try these on online. And I really found that to be a great thing that they offer. So definitely keep that in mind, especially if you are somebody who kind of varies between sizes.
Even though I am on the taller side, I have very short legs. Most of my height comes from my torso. So I also have a really tough time with the inseam length on denim. While I'm getting into wide leg and straight leg pants, I do love a good skinny jean, so I definitely wanted to try a skinny jean from this brand. When you look on their website, they offer several different options of skinny jeans, and while I was navigating all that, I felt a little bit confused and unsure of which one to try. I ended up deciding on the high-rise skinny bond in the color black. I don't own a pair of black jeans, and that's something that I've been meaning to add in my wardrobe for a long time, and I thought that no better time than now to try something like that from this brand. So you can purchase this denim in a 28 or 30 inch inseam, and I thought that that was great that they offered a variety of inseam lengths. And in terms of sizing, it goes from a 24 all the way up to a 33, which I think is great for them being super size inclusive. So I am definitely all for that. According to their website, this is the world's most flattering black skinny jeans. Bond keeps the deep black color with a fade resistant technology and keeps its shape with the perfect stretch and compression ratio. I'm going to give these a 4-star rating. So I found the rise to be great. That's something that I do struggle with sometimes, is finding a true high rise jean, but these fit great in terms of the rise. They're also super stretchy, which is something that can kind of go both ways for somebody. If you are somebody who likes a more rigid denim, I would say to definitely stay away from these jeans because they are super stretchy, almost kind of jegging like. They're also super thin, so that's something to note. And I would probably say that these are more of a spring summer weight denim rather than a fall winter denim. So the reason I'm giving this a 4-star rating instead of a 5-star rating is mostly because of the inseam length. Even at the shortest inseam, I still have to cuff these significantly. So I'm going to have to get these tailored in order for me to be able to wear them. I think for most people, a 28 inch inseam or a 30 inch inseam is going to work just fine. However, I will say, and I really encourage them as a brand to consider adding more 26 inch inseams, because that is a true ankle length for most people, or a regular length on short-legged people like me. Also, something else to keep in mind, if you are a pet owner, this is that type of material that's going to literally attract every inch of lint or hair. So that's just also something to keep in mind too. The final item I'm going to be talking about today is the Mom Ridge jeans. Now, these are jeans that I had so much high hopes for, because I am somebody who has been trying to find the perfect mom jeans, and one that has some stretch to it, because really rigid denim just does not work for my curvy body. So this is also another pair of jeans that has quite a bit of stretch to it. It's a little bit thicker, in my opinion, than the skinny jeans, but I'm going to have to give these a 3-star rating for a couple of reasons. These jeans go from a size 24 up to a 32, and they are offered in a 26 inch inseam or a 28 inch inseam. I received the one in the 28 inch inseam because they did not have the 26 in stock, and the 28 just looks super weird and awkward on me. I was also hoping that the ankle opening would be a lot more slim and tapered, which is something that I prefer with this style of jean. But because it doesn't do that, you know, I definitely can't wear these as is. This is also another pair of jeans that I'm gonna have tailored. I also found the rise of these to be a little bit strange. So these are a 10.5-inch rise, but they kind of dip in the front, almost like a V shape. So I found that to be a little weird. I also wish that these were like a true mom jean where they suck you in. And I just didn't find that with these jeans. Ridge is a medium weight denim with an old rose indigo color for a perfect, slightly worn in look. Stretch is added for comfort and a flattering fit. I'm so disappointed in these because I absolutely love the way that they look on the models, but also realistically, I look nothing like those models. If I get a chance to try the 26-inch inseam, I will definitely update you guys on that to let you know my thoughts and opinions on it. But as it stands, I find these to be just okay, not spectacular. Thank you so much for watching today's video. Let me know down in the comments below which item you are interested in trying from this brand after seeing my reviews, or some of your thoughts and opinions after hearing my honest review and reflections on these items that I've tried from this brand. I definitely think some of these pieces are worth it if you are in the market for certain basics. And I think that the price point is pretty good as well. They're definitely not cheap, but they're not gonna be such a high price point that they're gonna be unrealistic for most people to be able to afford. Remember, when it comes to your basics and the foundations of your wardrobe, it's always going to be quality over quantity. You want to be focusing on having fewer but higher quality pieces in your wardrobe when it comes to the basics and the foundations in which that you build your wardrobe on. Until next time, I'll catch you guys in my next video. Bye!